नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, srimahans, mahans, visitors, viewers, sitting through Nityananda TV, Facebook Live, YouTube Live, two-way video conferencing, having Nayanadiksha all over the world. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I'll enter into the next verse of the Kenopanishad. Chant along with me. Yanmanasa namanute yena hurmano matam tateva brahmatvam viddinetam yatitam upasate yanmanasa namanute yena hurmano matam tateva brahmatvam viddi netam yatitam upasate. The translation goes, that which cannot be thought of by the mind, that which is modified functions of intellect, intelligence, contemplation, cognition, but by which they say the mind is able to think and cognize, being illumined by the light of infinite cosmic intelligence. You must know that very source of mind, the reality alone as Brahman, the absolute existence, and not this which is worshipped and cherished here as a finite, limited object. I'll read out the verse once more. Yanmanasa namanute yena hurmano matam tateva brahmatvam viddinetam yatitam upasate. Again, Upanishad is repeating itself. Understand, unless it is too important, Upanishad does not repeat itself. Upanishad does not waste words. Unless it is too important. Understand, this truth, let your worship and worship objects be infinite. Even in the deep sleep, even when you are in deep sleep, if somebody wakes you up and asks, why are you working? immediate spontaneous response should not be money or power, name and fame, or any finite object. I am enriching through this work as enriching leads me to the space of Sadashiva. This should be the answer. Not just answer, cognition, understand. Work, quality, not only the work you do and the quality you carry as you. Whole thing should be directed towards infinite. Iron out your whole life with the truth of infinite. Let infinite be the source of life. Let the infinite be the source of existence. Let the infinite be the source of your joy. Understand? Yan manasa namanute yena hurmano matam tateva brahmatvam viddi netam yatitam upasate. That which cannot be thought of by the mind with its modified functions of intellect, intelligence, contemplation, cognition, but by which they say the mind is able to think and cognize, being illumined by the light of the infinite cosmic intelligence, you must know that very source of mind, that reality alone as Brahman. Please understand, Upanishad rarely repeats itself. If at all it is repeating itself, the concept, the sacred secret, the truth is too important. If it is not that important, it will not be repeating itself. Sometimes you feel you have not said what you really wanted to say. You feel the whole thing has not yet come out. It is still sitting. You delivered only the first baby. Second baby is still sitting inside. From morning I am exactly feeling like that to deliver the Tamil satsang in the evening. Don't miss tonight's Tamil satsang. It is going to be something extraordinary. I was actually afraid I may just start suddenly speaking in Tamil in the morning satsang, because the remaining is still sitting inside. The remaining, the climax part of the yesterday's satsang is still sitting inside. Does not it come out? Sometimes you feel the words are a small tube to drain the whole dam. Words are small tube to drain the whole dam. When words look too small to drain the whole dam, you will be forced to repeat. Yan manasa namanute yena hurmano matam తదేవ బ్రహ్మత్వం విద్దినేతం యతితం ఉపాసతే. ఐ కెన్ క్లియర్లీ అండర్స్టాండ్ ద ఉపనిషదిక్ రిషీస్ అండ్ దేర్ ఇన్నర్ స్పేస్. దే ఫీల్ వర్డ్స్ ఆర్ టూ స్మాల్ ట్యూబ్ టు డ్రెయిన్ ద హోల్ డ్యామ్. గంగా ఇస్ టూ బిగ్ టు బి డ్రెయిన్డ్ త్రూ అ స్మాల్ స్ట్రీమ్. Words are too small stream. Ganga is too big. So when it is too big, you have to repeat yourself. That is why Upanishad is repeating itself. Yan manasana manute yenahurmano matam tateva brahmatvam viddi ఏతం నేతం యతితం ఉపాసతే. ఉపనిషత్ ఇస్ రిపీటింగ్ ఇట్స్ సెల్ఫ్, గివింగ్ యూ వన్ మోర్ ఛాన్స్ ఫర్ లిసనింగ్. ఉపనిషత్ నోస్ హ్యూమన్ బీయింగ్స్ ఆర్ ఫూల్స్, దే మిస్ మెనీ టైమ్, బట్ ఇట్ కంటిన్యూస్ టు గివ్ వన్ మోర్ ఛాన్స్. It continues to provide one more chance. Don't look at what your mind shows. Look at what shows your mind to you. Not what your mind shows, but what shows your mind to you. Listen, your mind, when it shows something good or bad, don't get trapped. Even if you try to defend, it's a trap. Don't get trapped. Don't even say yes or no. Just be unclutched. That is the only way you can save yourself from any trap. Understand, when your mind says you are a failure, you are wrong, even if you try to solve that issue, you are trapped. No. Look who is showing you your mind. Don't look where your mind is showing you. Whether your mind shows about the hopes of the future, hopelessness of the past, whether your mind is showing you the possible victory of the future, or it is talking about the worst failures of the past, I tell you, the sad-faced victims are the biggest criminals. The sad-faced victims, oh, I am innocent, I am being tortured, tormented by life. They are worst criminals than the terrorists. Worst criminals than the terrorists. The cunningness they will be carrying inside, they will exhaust only if they live janmas as terrorists. Understand? Any energy you pile up inside, any pressure you build up inside has to be exhausted by you taking more and more janmas. Now, most of the fellows think that being victim, the victim faced, is the safest cozy corner you can hide. No, the pressure you build by supporting the idea you are a victim, you are innocent, you are being tortured and tormented, you can exhaust that pressure only by being a terrorist for janmas. A terrorist mind setup is built by you spending janmas as victim. If somebody takes birth in this janma in an ambience where he or she will become a terrorist, past janma they spent as the victim. With that victim mentality, whether your mind shows yourself as the victory of the future or victim of the past, don't listen to both. Look at the source which makes you experience your mind. Victory of the future, victim of the past. Both are trap. Listen to this word, trap. The moment you say yes, 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 for anyone, you are gone. You are gone. When the victory of the future appears in front of you, if you say yes, 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 you are trapped. When the feeling victim of the past appears in front of you, if you say yes, 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 you are trapped. Both are traps. Don't say yes or no to what your mind shows you. Always look at the source. Why you perceive your mind the way you perceive? Who is that making you perceive your mind as you perceive? The more and more you go down, the more and more you go to the depth, the more and more you go to the source, more and more you start seeing the root, more and more you will be enlightened. Tateva brahmatvam vitti netam yatitam upasate. No, the finite objects of your worship and worship, goal and goal mal, both if the finite is your goal or goal mal, you are caught. Let the goal of your worship or the goal of your worship be always source. Understand? If you think, if I am all the time looking for source, how will I run my regular life? This is the most practical instruction. Listen. Just if your cognition is turned, you can go on and on and on in your day-to-day life, living your practical life without tiredness, boredom, and friction. You think if you are an extrovert, it's a fuel for your life. If you turn as introvert, there won't be fuel for your life. I tell you, being introvert does not mean no fuel. It means huge lubrication for your system. It removes all the friction in the flow of your life. When you turn towards the source, the infinite, when you turn towards the source, infinite, the reality is experienced. The finite goals of your worship or worship is not ultimate. Remember this. Even the next 7th, 8th, 9th verses are the same truth repeated. Understand, Upanishad is repeating a truth 5 times. Continuously. Netam yatitam upasate, netam yatitam upasate, netam yatitam upasate, netam yatitam upasate, 5 times. Netam yatitam upasate, netam yatitam upasate, 5 times. Understand? Not once or twice, 5 times. Good news is, 5 times you will be given a chance to come back. Bad news is, if you make this missing as a pattern, you will miss even the 5th time. Good news is, 5 times you will be given a chance to come back. Bad news is, by the time if the missing has become pattern, you will miss even the 5th time. Netam yatitam upasate. Not these finite objects which are goal of worship and worship. They are not absolute. They are not ultimate. Netam yatitam upasate. Not once, 5 times. Kena Upanishad is repeating. Why it has to repeat 5 times? What is such an important sacred secret? Upanishad has to repeat itself 5 times because Upanishads are revealed to high frequency people. Not to the uncommitted, accidental onlookers. It is revealed to a committed, responsible individuals. It was literally like impregnating. Then why Kena Upanishad repeats itself 5 times? The answer for the why is in the next satsang. Listen. I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhadvaita Saivam, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.